Hello everyone. In this video, I would like to talk about the concept of the Savior. The concept of the Savior is existent within three Abrahamic religions: Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Now, before talking about how this concept is related to these religions, I want to bring to your attention some common aspects. Number one, all three, they believe in a God. They all have their own holy scriptures. They all believe in heaven and hell, and they all have prophets and messengers who preached, and they all believe in the coming of a Savior. Now let's talk about Judaism. In Judaism, they believe that the Savior comes from the line of King David. There is this well-known theologian that once said, whose name was Rabbi Ramdam, "I believe with perfect faith in the coming of the Mashiach, and though he may tarry, still I await him every day." Principle 12 of Rambam's 13 Principles of Faith. Now there are several indications within the Old Testament that the Savior will arrive. One of them is, he lifts up a banner for the distant nations. He whistles for those at the ends of the earth. Here they come swiftly and speedily. And there's also another verse which says, "Who is this coming from Edom, from Bozrah, with his garments stained crimson? Who is this robed in splendor, striding forward in the greatness of his strength? It is I, proclaiming victory, mighty to save." Now we have addressed the Savior concept within Judaism. Let's go to Christianity. Now in Christianity, of course, you might have already guessed that a lot of Christians believe that Jesus is their Savior. And they believe in the second coming of Jesus. And they use this verse to prove that he will come again. For example, "I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." Now we have addressed Judaism, we addressed Christianity. What is left now is Islam. Now in Islam, you have Sunnis and you have 12 Shias, the two most populated sects within Islam. Both Sunnis and Shias, they believe in the Prophet Muhammad. And they have reliable books which contain narrations about the Mahdi, the Savior, and have narrations from the Prophet that the Mahdi is from the daughter of Fatima. A Sunni narration would be, "The Mahdi will be of my family, of the descendants of Fatima, the Prophet's daughter." And a Shia narration would be, "From the Prophet Muhammad, he said, after placing his hand on Hussein, who's Fatima's son, 'The Mahdi of my nation that will spread justice and peace after iniquity and justice is from his children,'" meaning Hussein. The Sunni's Mahdi, their hadiths say that his name is similar to that of the Prophet Muhammad, and the Mahdi's father has a name similar to the Prophet's father. The Mahdi of the 12 Shias, he's the ninth descendant from Hussein, Fatima's son. His name is Imam Muhammad, son of Al-Hasan. Here is his lineage, the lineage of Imam Muhammad, son of Al-Hasan. So, right now, we have proven that the Savior concept is existent within all three Abrahamic religions. There is more that will be discussed in the next video, so please stay tuned.